many times or all the times who you are, who you really are, is far ahead of the current realities you see around you. Amen. And the reasons are simple. One of the reasons is God does not expose great seed quickly, so the devil does not kill it. When Jesus was born and those men were following the star, they could locate Jesus. But when God saw that they entered the house of Herod, and Herod will look for the child to kill, when they entered the house of Herod, God disappeared the star. He hid the destiny of Jesus. And when those wise men did not come back to Herod, Herod said, kill all the children that are 2 years old. God hid the star and took Jesus away from that territory. Why was God hiding it? Because when you are exposed too early, there is damage, there is destruction. So what God does is to take a mighty destiny and put it in a little container and blind the eyes of everybody. Even your parents don't see who you are. Even your brother, that's why when you look at the child and say, look at you, yeah, see the way they behave like mumu, you don't know you are talking to the president of a nation. Even your parents don't have the capacity to see it. Even your closest brothers and sisters don't really know who you are, because God has packaged that greatness and hid it. But listen to me, when the time comes, God said, listen, you are not only going to be praying and say, oh Lord, give my family blessing, we are poor. That is a kindergarten prayer. God said, ask of me, I will give you nations. Aye. Ask of me, I will take you to that reality. Abraham had no child yet, God said, I will give you nations. He had no child yet, God said, out of you I will multiply your seed. I don't have a seed, where will the seed multiply from? God said, you don't understand. You see the now, but I see the future. I am the one who ended a thing before I began it. Do you understand that? Men, when they want to start something, you will start it and then watch the end. God has seen the end, then he began it. He has seen your end from your beginning. That was why he said, Esau have I hated, Jacob have I loved. Not because he had preferential treatment, but he has seen their life. He has seen the decision that just Jacob will make, the decision that Esau will make. And based on their decision, he said, this one will serve this one, and so this one will have my favor. Are you listening to me? So God is saying that whilst you are seated here, I have nations to give to you. Where you have no one in your family lineage have ever gone, that is where you will go. There are some of you listening to me, it won't be long from now. You will stand delivering some speeches in some very high places, and all your audience will be white men and white women. All. You will be talking to them, and they'll have to learn your accent. They have to hear you. I'm not just speaking this morning, I am prophesying. I'm prophesying. They said, ask for. Can I give you 1 minute in your seated position to ask for something more than what you have been asking? Jesus.